Hey guys, welcome back to another day experimenting with hot versus cold. Now, for months and months now, even before I was playing with liquid nitrogen and gasoline, I've had hundreds and hundreds of people asking me to mix gasoline with dry ice, to light dry ice on fire, and to drop dry ice into burning gasoline. So today we're going to be trying all three of those experiments just to observe what happens. So today I picked a comment by Bonnie in the Box who says, gasoline versus dry ice, make it happen. So we're doing this for you, Bonnie, and for everyone else who suggested the same thing. Okay, disclaimer. Gasoline is a very volatile substance and it can lead to a fire that gets out of control very, very quickly. This is not an experiment I can recommend trying at home because if something goes terribly wrong, you may no longer have a home. All right, for our first experiment, let's try drilling a hole into a block of ice, then using some gasoline to fill up that hole and observe how the two materials react. Oh, look at that. We ended up making dry ice snow. So I just used a Forstner bit to drill a hole right in the center of this block of dry ice, and it runs about 3/4 to 1 inch deep. And over here, I filled up a measuring cup with 91 octane. So let's go ahead and pour it in and see what happens. This is actually a little more than I'm comfortable working with, so I'm gonna pour some of that out. I'm gonna start off just putting a couple of small drops in there. This makes a little hissing noise. If I blow the vapor away, you can actually see the liquid gasoline in there. Pouring a little bit more. I wonder if the dry ice can freeze it. You know, gasoline, I believe, starts to freeze around 40 degrees Fahrenheit, and the dry ice is around minus 109. It settles down relatively quickly. It still seems pretty liquidy. All right, so gasoline in dry ice doesn't really seem to do much. It's just kind of sitting there chilling. I'm sure it's getting colder, but I don't see any reaction with the carbon dioxide. So while we've got this cooling over here, I'm gonna flip things over the other way, chisel off a small piece of dry ice, and drop it into a glass full of gas. Got a small piece of dry ice here. It's about the size of a quarter. I'm very comfortable working with that. Let's drop it in and see what happens. Contact. Ooh, a vigorous boil. Oh gosh. I keep thinking it's gonna spill it out of the glass, and then it settles down. Now what's happening here is the gasoline is warming up the block of dry ice and the dry ice is sublimating and releasing carbon dioxide gas, which means we effectively have a barrier of carbon dioxide right here, which makes me wonder if we lit off a match and tried to light the gasoline at this point, would the carbon dioxide put the match out or would the gasoline still light off? We might have to try. Moment of truth. Oh, we've got a barrier that prevents the gasoline from being lit. Without oxygen, our gasoline can't burn, and now we've got a protective layer preventing any open flames getting down to it. Interesting. So now thinking about this, let's try taking it to the next level. Do you think we can actually use gasoline to put out a match? If we had a flaming match and dunked it down into the liquid, could we do it in such a way that the match goes out and nothing catches fire? I think if we have a small barrier of carbon dioxide on the top to prevent any oxygen from getting in, it just might be possible. So our dry ice is just starting to settle down, which means we should have a nice layer of carbon dioxide in here. So if we strike a match, theoretically, we should be able to drop it down to liquid and have gasoline put the match out. You think it'll work? All right, here we go. Gasoline versus match in 3, 2, 1, drop. And it goes out. That is beautiful. That is a beautiful thing. We just use gasoline to put out a fire. That's a mind blow. This really is gasoline, guys, and to prove that, we can blow off the carbon dioxide layer and touch it off with a match and it should light off. Just like that. So you can see that by dipping our match very quickly through a small layer of carbon dioxide into the gasoline actually puts the match out. Now to put out a gas fire like this, we can just take a damp rag, very carefully place it over top for 1 to 2 seconds, and just like magic, it's gone out. All right, so back to our gasoline in the dry ice. It's been sitting here for about 15 minutes, and I can see the top layer is starting to crust over a little bit, so it looks like over time, our gasoline will actually freeze, but it takes an extremely long time to do that. So since we're still waiting for that, I'm gonna drill a small hole in the block of dry ice, fill it up with a little bit more gasoline, and light that one off. I'm just gonna take that snow and dump it over here into the gasoline. See if that speeds the reaction at all. Vigorous. Cool, let's light that off. All right, here we go. Oh, I can't get the light. Well, let me blow out some of that carbon dioxide layer first. Huh, that didn't work either. So update, guys, I've tried about 8 times and I cannot get the gasoline in this small hole of dry ice to light off. So let's chisel the frozen gasoline out of the center hole, fill it up, and see if a bigger hole makes a difference. This stuff right here is frozen gasoline. We know what that does, right? Let's see. Nope, not even getting that to light. Gasoline versus dry ice. Dry ice wins. All right, that's filled up completely to the top. Let's go ahead and light it off while it's hot. 3, 2, 1. And it goes out. Every single time it goes out, I cannot get this stuff to light off. It's crazy. Even if I blow off the carbon dioxide vapor first, the match still goes out. I cannot get gasoline to light off in dry ice. All right, guys, so even with big, healthy flames, so far I'm having 0 success lighting gasoline in dry ice. You can see little bits of gasoline spurting up and igniting. But once we get it down to the liquid itself, it goes out every time. We know that this is because the carbon dioxide is acting as a barrier, preventing any oxygen from getting to the gasoline. And the liquid gasoline itself isn't flammable, so we can stick a match right down inside it, and it goes right out. So the only way to get any kind of flaming effect, I think, is to light a container of gasoline on fire first, and then throw some chunks of dry ice into it next. And this could get extremely dangerous, so for this last experiment, we're going outside. All right, let's light her up. Goes off, no problem. All right, one chunk of dry ice, what's it gonna do? Just bubbles and spatters and shoots gasoline out. Let's throw in a bigger chunk. Oh wow, look at it spread. I wonder if we threw a few chunks of dry ice down into the flames, what would happen? Wow, that's a lot of gas. You know what's gonna happen is that glass is gonna break and gasoline is gonna go everywhere. But look at the dry ice, it's starting to put out the flames. It's on fire, but the flames can't keep up because the dry ice and the carbon dioxide is putting it out. I'm gonna go get some more dry ice. Look at the cup actually went out, the flame went out. Oh my gosh, that's so cool. So fire versus dry ice wins. That was incredible. That was a fire that was starting to get out of control and the dry ice just took it down. And now watch this. If I try lighting off another match and igniting the gasoline, it won't go off. The match just goes right out because that, it actually put out the flame. Even on the ground, did you see that? Even on the ground, the flame went out. Can't get the cup to go off. The gasoline down here. Can't even get that to light off. The matches just go out. What about a whole bundle of matches? They all just go out. That is cool. That is cool. Oh, whoop. I like that. Gonna slip it in there slowly. It starts bubbling and spitting, and now look, because it's a bigger container, it's producing carbon dioxide inside the container, and the flames are having a hard time keeping up. Here's another piece. Flame just went out. So on the large bowl, by putting chunks of dry ice in there very carefully, it actually suppressed the flame and made it go out. And at this point, I can't light it off. I'm relatively comfortable standing right over top of it with an open match right now and trying to light it, because nothing happens, it just goes right out. So a lot of really interesting things learned here today. We started off this experiment by pouring gasoline into a hole that we made in a chunk of dry ice. Now after the initial shock of the two temperatures meeting, the gasoline settled down and nothing more really seemed to happen. So we set that to the side for a minute and we flipped the experiment by dropping small chunks of dry ice into a cup full of gasoline to see if we could produce any different results. We saw that the reaction of the dry ice sublimating inside the gasoline caused the gas to bubble up and foam at the top, and in some cases even spill over the edge. We also discovered that the gasoline was covered by a thin coating of carbon dioxide gas, which would prevent an open flame from lighting it off. So we tried an experiment to see if we could use gasoline to actually put out a fire, and it worked every time. We went back to our block of dry ice, drilled a bigger hole, and tried to light off the gas with absolutely no success. So for our final experiment, we went outside with a container of gasoline, lit it on fire first, and dropped in chunks of dry ice after. In the first container, the dry ice made the gasoline spew out into the open air, where it quickly accelerated into an uncontrollable flame. So we tried taking chunks of dry ice and setting them down into the flames, and in less than a minute, our gas fire had been completely smothered. But in the second round, we used a larger bowl with more surface area and slowly slipped the dry ice inside. But even though the liquid was burning with a healthy flame, as the carbon dioxide rose from below, it smothered the flame and put the fire out. So in conclusion, I think that we've seen, when it comes to fire versus dry ice wins. And a big thanks to Bonnie in the box for leaving this suggestion in the comments. You can go ahead and check your YouTube inbox, Bonnie. I'm sending you $25. Well, that's it for this experiment, guys. Thanks for joining me, and I'll be looking for you in the next video. Talk to you then. Oh, yikes. Don't really want that stuff spilling everywhere. It's not gonna be good for the general health and safety of the people who live here.
Not even our improvised napalm can keep